Still going, Dermot. Inside to Platt, and that is Platt in. Platt of Wigan wants to tell us. Yes, it's the big league's night of nights. Bradford's win on Tuesday has set up a thrilling end of the season, and simply Wigan must win tonight or a great many people will be ready to hail new big league champions. Great crowd is packing into Central Park. They're expecting well in excess of 20,000 for this, the decider for the big league championship. Welcome to a packed and vibrant Central Park. It really is going to be a magnificent evening here in Lancashire tonight, and the big league title, there's no doubt about it, it is up for grabs. The victory by Bradford on Tuesday has set us up with the most thrilling end of the season that we've had in years. And Steve-O, I'll tell you something, it's a tremendous atmosphere and a great night.
The tension, it's mounting. It's just going to be one of those days where I think that both sides really know that this is a crunch game. It's like a cup final, the championship, premiership, it's all rolled into one tonight at Central Park. And it's a great thing for Wigan that they've got Clark back. I didn't think he'd make it. A lot of doubt must be in it. We mentioned yesterday, Eddie, about on boots and all. I said that one of the coaches, perhaps, maybe both, will take a gamble on using players that are not 100% fit. I wonder whether Phil Clark is 100%.
Well, we shall find out as this match unfolds, and let us now bring you that news that Phil Clark is in that Wigan side. Let's check out the Wigan team for you. Wigan, champions for the past four seasons. Gary Connolly continues at fullback, a position he began his career in at St Helens. There's a change for Wigan, a big change. Viaga Twigamala replaces the injured Jason Robinson on the wing. Dean Bell, the captain, is back for Wigan. He played at Bradford, this tonight only his second game out of the last 30. Sam Panifa is alongside him. A try against Bradford here last season. Martin Ofaya scored his first ever Wigan try against Bradford in January 1992. Frano Botica has scored an incredible 112 points against Bradford in 4 years as a pro. Sean Edwards, his try on Tuesday wasn't enough to prevent a Bradford victory. Kelvin Skerritt is the former Bradford prop forward who joined Wigan in 1990. Martin Hall continues at hooker in place of the injured Martin Dermott. Andy Platt has missed out on a league title success just once in his career here at Central Park. Second row sees Dennis Betts starting only his second game since December. And Neil Cowie scored his sixth try of the season against Halifax here last Thursday. Two changes for Wigan tonight from the side that lost at Bradford, and there's the big boost for them. Phil Clark comes back. It was thought that he was struggling for Wembley, but he's fit for tonight. And the coach, he says his men are ready for this battle, John Dorahy. Look at the crowd inside Central Park, and we've still got over 20 minutes to kick-off time. One of the biggest nights of the season, this, and of course the challengers Bradford Northern, saved by a whisker from relegation 2 years ago. What a transformation in their fortunes. Neil Summers has recovered from hamstring trouble. He plays at fullback tonight. Carl Hall, seven tries in eight games for the New Zealander since he arrived at Oddsall from Doncaster. Dio Powell is the Welsh international, a try against Castleford on Sky last Friday. Paul Newlove is one of the world's best, the second division champion with Featherstone last year, first division this year, I wonder. Gerald Caudle, he has never scored at Central Park. He came so close to a try on Tuesday night. David Watson's back after suspension. He returned on Tuesday and he played very well. Derek Fox at scrum half needs two tries for a career century in club and representative football. What a night to get them tonight. Roy Powell plays his 80th consecutive game for Bradford since he joined them from Leeds. Trevor Clark's the hooker. He had to be content with the substitute's role last season, but he's played in all but one of 35 matches this term. Adam Greenwood has been in outstanding form against Castleford and then Wigan in the past week. Paul Dixon was a champion with Halifax in 1986. He's a former Great Britain international. Paul Medley scored a try the last time Bradford won here at Central Park in the Regal Trophy 4 years ago. And Carl Fairbank completes the lineup. His try in the third minute of the second half on Tuesday was absolutely priceless. The coach, he led them to the title in 1981. Will he do the same again 13 years on? It's Peter Fox, of course. That's the scene then for this match of match. It really is, Steve-O, the night of nights for the big league, this.
I think so. I think it's all going to come down to the fact that Oucht starts controlling the game very early in the piece. We know that Wigan lost at Bradford on Tuesday, and that would have been a real shock to their system. And I think that this is going to be the night that Sean Edwards really, really fires. Won't be easy against a man like Derek Fox. Derek Fox, more content, I think, to be more of a role with the kicking. But I think that Sean Edwards will start taking on the defence. I think he'll start running at them. And we saw with that individual try on Tuesday night that he is back to form, and there's nothing better to bring out the best in Sean Edwards than a big game like tonight.
We'll see highlights, by the way, of that victory for Bradford on Tuesday after the next break. But Steve-O, how important is that win for Bradford, bearing in mind what they've got to face here tonight? Not just Wigan, but 25,000 screaming Central Park fans.
It was desperate for Bradford. They had to win on Tuesday night because no team likes to come to Central Park. It is one of the hotbeds of rugby league, and Wigan, to my knowledge, have only lost once at home this season. And Derek Fox, he knows the importance of the kicking game today. When they did win, I think they realised that they were on the verge of becoming worthy champions. Their coach Peter Fox has been very laid back all the way through the season, saying that we're not ready to become champions. Well, tonight they could be.
We shall see. And the Bradford players, as you see, they're out on the pitch sampling this atmosphere, and it is some atmosphere, believe me. Don't miss a minute of this one here on Sky Sports tonight. Central Park is filling up, and this famous ground awaits one of the best matches of the season. Wigan Bradford next.
Seize the day.
You're watching Sky Sports.
It's Wigan against Bradford, the big league title decider on Sky Sports tonight. I wonder whether it will be. Bradford Northern getting used to this unique Central Park atmosphere. And this night was all set up courtesy of a great win at Oxel on Tuesday for Bradford Northern against Wigan. Bill Arthur was there for the big league.
It was the biggest ever Division 1 home crowd in Bradford's history. Just over 14,000 packed the terraces, and both sets of fans were optimistic.
I reckon we'll win. I reckon we'll win on Friday, and I reckon it's our league again. Because they like being at Central Park, these cups.
You don't sound very confident.
I'm not.
I think that Bradford North are going to win, and then win the championship.
Well, if we win tonight, it's ours. They'll not beat us at Wigan.
It's got to be a hard match, but I think Northern should pull through. With Foxy's kicking, we should win it.
And those fans weren't disappointed as the heavyweights slugged it out with some spectacular defending. Gary Connolly pulling off a vital early tackle on Gerald Cordell. And just when it seemed that Frano Botico was going to dance his way through the Northern defence, Neil Summers pulled off an equally good tackle. Eventually, the defences had to crack, and it was Wigan who cracked first. Carl Hall spotting a gap, beating Connolly and going over. But just before half-time, Wigan got back into the game. A typical piece of cheeky play from Sean Edwards, helped by Kelvin Skerritt, going over the line. That lead didn't last long. 3 minutes into the second half, a little sidestep from Dave Watson wrong-footed the Wigan defence, and Carl Fairbank plunged over. Bradford could have increased their lead. Fairbank involved again in a move that saw Newlove set Gerald Caudle away. And when it seemed as though Caudle was over, somehow Connolly got his hands to the ball. With some spirited defending, Bradford held on for a victory that sets up tonight's thriller here at Central Park.
Fantastic, really. Just goes to show the character of the Bradford Northern players. As soon as the final whistle went, everybody turned around to each other and says, that's only half a job done. Even though we can celebrate for a few hours tonight, there's still a lot of hard work to be done for Friday, because we're going to Central Park, there's going to be a big crowd there, and we're going to have to really, really grind his metal.
We've got to do it. We didn't do it tonight, and, you know, get his heads together 2 days away and go for it.
And tonight, a showdown between Wigan coach John Dorohay and the wily veteran, Bradford's Peter Fox.
Our most important game of the season comes up on Friday night for Wigan.
Do you think it's going to be just as tight?
I would expect so, yeah. You know, they've certainly put their nose in front, and the way that they perform tonight, Bradford, I would think that they will try as much again on Friday night as what they did tonight.
I just ask the lads, just do this one for me. I don't care what happens the rest of the season, you've done the two that I wanted doing. Castleford, when we were chalked off, everybody, all the media men, scrubbed us again. But we came back against Castleford and took them by surprise. And we've done this one again, and we've set the season up brilliantly.
Haven't they just? If it's as good a night tonight as it was on Tuesday, we're in for a treat. And the hot news for the Wigan fans, and it's just circulating Central Park, is that Phil Clark returns to the team. What a boost that is for Wigan. Let's take a look at the head-to-head over the years. It's on as even between these two. Of 37 games played in the First Division over the past 20 years, Wigan have won 18, Bradford 17. There have been just the two draws. Now we have the best defence in the big league on show tonight against the best attack. Wigan have conceded 371 points. That's all in their matches so far. Bradford have conceded over 100 more, but look at that. They have run in 700 points. They boast the best attack. The story of the season so far, Bradford, they are top, Wigan a third, both with three games to go. Both have lost, well, far too many for their coach's comfort, I'm sure. The champions, whoever they are, don't lose again here tonight. And the table, as we go into this evening's match, sees Bradford on top with 42 points. And Warrington, you know, they could sneak in to the calculations if Wigan win. It's a vital night for the top three. Fabulous game in prospect here on Sky Sports. Don't miss a minute of it. Kick-off time scheduled for 7:30. I bet the atmosphere is white hot downstairs. Let's go down pitch side and join Bill Arthur.
Sure is, Eddie. There's going to be a crowd of over 20,000 they anticipate here tonight, and conditions very different from what you saw at Oddsall on Tuesday night when it was tipping it down and the pitch was a mud bath. Here the pitch is in great shape, but I have to tell you that groundsman Derek Jones is heartbroken because he's actually had to put some sand on his beloved pitch, and he hates doing that. But the pitch is very firm indeed, and it looks it's going to stay that way because the forecast is that it's going to be mainly dry with some clouds. Northerly winds of 15 to 20 miles an hour and temperature falling to around 3 degrees, so just about a perfect night for this game. One man who will be sitting on the sidelines, I'm sure, keen to be out here, is the former Wigan and Great Britain forward Ian Lucas, who had to retire last year because of a neck injury. And I should imagine, Ian, you've been in this situation before. You know what those players will be feeling right now.
That's right. They're very, very tense tonight. We had this situation a couple of seasons ago when we had a run of 10 games up to the end of the season, and we ended up playing Leeds at Eden late in the last game. They'll be very tense. Wigan will be fired up. They're used to the big games, and I'm sure they'll cope with it okay.
I mentioned the conditions. It was muddy at Oddsall. It's dry here. Do you think they will play a part?
Oh, definitely, especially for the Wigan team. I mean, the muddy conditions of Oddsall would suit the big pack of the Bradford Northerns club. But here tonight, perfect conditions for rugby league, perfect conditions for open rugby, and I think it'll suit Wigan down to the ground.
But Bradford, having won on Tuesday night, maybe just have that psychological edge.
Yeah, but I think it'll work to Wigan's advantage because Wigan, they've gone down once, they know what's at stake. If they lose tonight, they're out of the competition, and they don't want to be out of the competition.
Ian Lucas, great to see him, and looking very fit indeed, the former Wigan player. Bill Arthur was talking there, Steve-O, about the pitch. Now, we saw the pictures from Hotspur on Tuesday night, and it was a glue pot. The pitch tonight is firm. Is it Wigan's going, or is it Bradford's?
It's got to be Wigan's. I mean, when you've got men like Martin O'Fired and Twigamala on the wing, they've got to start favourites. But can they get the ball out to the wings? That is a big problem. Defence is going to be a very big key. The fact that the forwards have got to work hard, the forwards, it's going to be fiery. Skerritt, Fairbank, like two dogs in a butcher's shop. It's going to be very, very keen. I wouldn't miss this for the world.
It's going to be a great game, no doubt about it. And I would think that the likes of, what? The forwards, you've mentioned them, the likes of Skerritt and Fairbank, and of course there's stars on both sides who really can turn this match.
Yeah, the advantage of it is it's interesting to note that both coaches have selected two forwards on the substitute bench. One of them, Mick Cassidy. Now, this guy really has come on his own this season. He's been one of the stars for Wigan. When Wigan were just rocking somewhat, this guy just kept going and going. And it's going to be important when John Dory brings on Cassidy into the game. That could be a key factor. Bring him on, right point, and he could have the extra legs to just swing it Wigan's way.
Well, he's only 20, and he really has established himself in this Wigan side this year, hasn't he?
My word, he's a star for the future. Just got in the Great Britain squad. He'll be itching to get out there. It's not that he's been demoted, believe you me. He's out there, he's on the bench, and he's there to do a mission. And the mission is probably when he comes out in the second half.
Cassidy, then watch out for him. And the other man, that of course, that we should watch out for, particularly on the Bradford side, Paul Newlove, who for me, Steve, has developed into one of the best in the world this season.
Well, there's no doubt about it. Look at the man. He's big, he's strong, he's got the ability. Look at the upper body strength there. And look at those legs driving, bouncing through. Give him the opportunity and he will make Wigan suffer. He's the man, he's a key. Look at this. Strength palming off. He can make a try out of nothing. He's not just speed, this guy. He's skill and strength.
Yes, he is certainly one of the stars that's on show here tonight. There's no doubt about that. Stars are plenty. In fact, you look down that list and there are internationals in virtually every position. The cream of the big league on show here tonight. Who's going to win it?
I think I've got to go for Wigan, providing that Sean Edwards does attack the Bradford defence and they can get the ball out wide. My only doubt is the fact they've selected Twigamala. He's good when he's going forward, but he's not been in this game long enough to understand positioning and defensive quality, and that could let Wigan down tonight. But it's going to be close.
It is going to be close, and of course the stars are out on the big league tonight. The stars come out and the crowds roll out as well. We have a huge crowd inside Central Park tonight. The title decider. Don't miss a minute of it. Kick off at 7:30.
Seize the day.
The Wigan and Bradford public have turned out in force for this one. Bradford Northern aiming for a first title in 13 years. And victory tonight would put them 4 points clear with just two games to go. Bradford have brought between 5,000 and 6,000 supporters with them across the Pennines for this one. To meet the champions who need to win all three remaining fixtures to lift a fifth successive league title. And maybe again it will go down to points difference. Wigan, the champions, the champion team, the one they've all had to match. And my word, haven't they matched Wigan this season? Bradford Northern and Warrington have pushed them all the way. A thrilling climax to the season, and you'll be able to enjoy this one with us, I'm sure, here on Sky Sports tonight. Steve-O, the youngsters out in force as well. This is going to be a battle royal.
Yes, at least they are in the safe position. The 13 gladiators, it will be fire all the way.
Bradford Northern in the away strip. 4 days, of course, since the big match at Oxford on Tuesday. And Derek Fox that night had an absolute blinder. He outshone Sean Edwards, and that doesn't happen very often. Fox needs 2 tries for 100 in his career. And there is Peter Fox, the Bradford coach. Talking to him last night, he said the boys are ready for the battle to come. Medley, the second row forward, had a great game on Tuesday also. But here come the champions. They know that this is their moment of truth. Quite a night. And Phil Clark back to boost the Wigan pack. Clark injured at Hulkingston Rovers just last Sunday. Spoke to him on Tuesday night after the match at Oddsall. He said that he was struggling to make it for Wembley. But here he is tonight, and what a boost for Wigan that is. And Dean Bell, the Wigan captain, comes back to the action. Only his second appearance in the last 30. 9 tries against Bradford down the years. Former New Zealand Test international. Another boost for Wigan that he's back for this business end of the big league campaign. The Wigan side for you, let's confirm it. Connolly is at fullback. Twigamala, Bell, Panapa, Ofaya, Botica and Edwards. Up front, Skerritt, Hall and Platt, Betts, Cowie and Clark. And the substitutes, Mick Cassidy and Anthony Farrell. Inga the winger. Only his 7th appearance in the big league since he switched from the All Blacks earlier this year. And this is without doubt the biggest game he's played. Bradford Northern, Summers at fullback, Hall, Powell, Newlove and Caudle, Watson and Fox. Up front, Powell, Clark, Greenwood, Dixon, Medley and Furbank. They're at full strength. And on the bench, David Heron and John Hamer. 2 forwards, though Heron can play standoff. Match referee is John Holdsworth from Kippax, 47 years old. 2 Challenge Cup finals, 4 Eagle trophies, 6 premierships, 7 internationals. A big man for a big occasion. Relishes the big atmosphere at the top of the Stones Bitter Championship. And that's what we have here tonight. Wigan against Bradford. It really is winner takes all. Great atmosphere. Electric inside Central Park. And Wigan it is who will kick off. Frano Bodega will get this battle of battles underway. Hold on to your hats, this will be a belter. Underneath it is Watson. He gives it to Dixon. First collision with Skerritt. We're off already.
And expect more of that. There's more to come. But that would end there. Skerritt is fired up. 2 big tackles in the first few seconds.
Last time I saw Kelvin Skerritt get wound up at the start, that's 3 on the row for the big Wigan prop forward, was in the semi-final against Castleford. But look at this run from Furbank. The support is there from Clark, and Bradford spring from defence into attack.
Super run from the loose forward, Furbank. He's in outstanding form.
Watson sees a gap. He has got Carl Hall with him, pulls him inside. The support is there from Powell. He gives it to his namesake, but it's a penalty to Bradford. The referee, John Holmes, was spotting someone being pulled back without the ball.
Newlove getting it there, and you can see that Powell was taken out by Cowie well before he received it, but super play, the inside pass, Watson scything through the gap. Quite clearly, Cowie, the second rower, scything down the prop forward, Roy Powell. And surely this must be a gift, 2 points. But what a break from Carl Furbank. When everyone in this ground expected that Wigan's defence would apply the pressure, the loose forward strode through magnificently.
Now this is a test of Derek Fox's nerve here, and it's one that will settle down the Bradford jitters if he kicks this. Not difficult. And Fox has hit the post, and it's bounced over. Oh, Derek Fox breathes a sigh of relief. Bradford Northern breathes a sigh of relief. They have the lead.
This is the break that put them through there. You could see they were very slow in the second marker division. Super support play from Trevor Clark. And once again, it was Gary Connolly that came to the rescue, as he did so many times on Tuesday night.
What a start to this match then. What a start for Bradford. Here's Paul Medley. The Wigan forwards, though, are tearing into the tackles. Watson, the dummy half. That's Dixon. Skerritt and Cowie with the tackle. Clark, the acting halfback. Here's Roy Powell. Panapa in there. So too Dennis Betts. Good tackling this by Wigan, but Bradford, remember, snapped from this position into an attacking mode with a run like this from Newler. Newler down the line, Corbin's on his outside, waiting for the pass. Newler still going on, Edwards there, Connolly there. But should Newlove have passed the ball out wide?
No, I think he did the right thing. There wasn't much room to move out there. Perhaps they would have gone into touch. That was good thinking in my part from Newlove. But it was a bad missed tackle from Dean Bell. Remember, Bell has been out for such a long time.
Last tackle for Bradford. What a confident start by the league leaders. The diagonal kick from Fox. Cordles after it. Oh, the ball, though, just went out on the bounce.
That nearly caught Freno Botica there. We've seen it so many times. It's a cross and back kick from Cox, and Cordle knew it was on. It was a planned move, and Botica was caught out then.
I know they have this match on the big screen back at Odsall Stadium, Steve. What a start for Bradford Northern here.
Well, a lot of people thought that Bradford may be intimidated by Central Park, the big crowd, but they have come out meaning business. They want to play football, and they've got the power to do it.
Kelvin Skerritt in possession, though, for Bradford. Great run from Skerritt. Watson there. So too Adam Greenwood. Hall the dummy half to Clark. Clark taken off at Hulkingston Rovers last week with an injury. He thought it would keep him out of Wembley. A great boost for Wigan that he's here tonight. That's a high kick from Edwards. Summers is underneath it. Collects it for Bradford. He gets away from Panapa. This is a sensational run from Summers. The fire's after him. And a fire wheels him in. But what another break from Bradford Northern. They're cutting Wigan to ribbons at the moment.
Sean Edwards there. Kicking the man. He never went for the football. Aimed at the foot of Neil Summers, who had done the right thing. What a wonderful break. But that is the second time that this Wigan defence, and there you can see Sean Edwards saying, come on, let's get this defence sorted out.
What a run this was from Neil Summers, though, Steve-O.
But he should have been stopped there. Sam Panapa just clutching at the shirt. It's all about tackling around the legs, and fortunate for Wigan that they've got the speed of Martin Afaya to come back and recover the situation.
Fox fancies his chances for another two here. Bang in front, but what, 20, 30, 38 metres out. And this time he's off target. But importantly for Bradford, the ball does go dead, so they will get it back from the dropout on the 20-metre line. But look at Summers. Only his third appearance at full-back for Bradford. That was a terrific run from him. Botica with the dropout. Bradford then will get it straight back.
Well, bad mistake there from Carl Hall. He should have allowed that to go. He should never attempted at it. And look how he grimaced on the face. Dearie me, mistake. But it's pressure. Remember, was with Doncaster up until recently. Certainly has proved a wonderful buy for Bradford.
So as a result of that little mistake from Carl Hall, it's Wigan who have the head and feet at this scrum. They really have been let off the hook there. Can they turn this now to their advantage? Botica to Edwards. A night for Sean Edwards to stamp his authority on this match. Here's Phil Clark. And he's hauled down. It was Furbank and Powell doing the tackling. 2-0 Bradford. Wigan with their first chance, really. This is Cowie. Great driving run from Cowie. Look at that possession statistic in the opening 6 minutes. It's been all Bradford. But it's now Wigan with Edwards to Bell. To Panapa. Trying to go through the gap. Panapa. Good tackling again by Bradford. Bell. Wigan attacking down the short side with Betts. And that's the last Wigan tackle. Edwards. Call Platt onto that. Good tackling. Summers. It's the automatic turnover.
Super low tackle from Neil Summers, a fullback. That's how to stop the big man. Big, fast and strong. It doesn't matter. They can't go without the legs.
Kelvin Skerritt against his former club, and he really is all wound up for this, the big league decider. Bradford in possession, masters of their own destiny now after a dreadful Easter.
lost 3 out of 4 over the holiday period, but they have bounced back and they know that this is their moment tonight.
Not only have they bounced back, but Bradford are playing the ball so quickly. They're catching this Wigan defence, still going on the back with Boatman.
Carney reached for that, wanted to take it at pace and did so, but the opportunity is closed down. Bradford moving up very quickly to cut his options down. Martin Hall is the dummy half to Cowie. Cowie stands in the tackle. Martin Hall stayed there in support. He is hauled down 10 yards inside the Bradford half of the field. Cowie to Edwards, to Botica. Scampering run from Botica. He finds Panapa. A fire has drifted from one wing to the other. Clark gets the ball from him. Good tackle though by Newlove. There's a fire again. Here's Botica. Now it's Edwards directing the traffic. Platt trying to run straight over the top of Adam Greenwood. Greenwood felt that. This is Edwards. Edwards dabs the ball forward straight into the arms of Paul Dixon. Betts following up with the tackle for Wigan.
The option was good from Sean Edwards. But the second row, Paul Dixon was equal to the task.
Space here for Carl Hall. Has got a fire to get round and can't do so, and helped out by Cowie, who had a little whisper in Carl Hall's ear there, I think. That's a slack pass. Clark has snapped onto it. That's a mistake. And Clark held down there while Bradford's defence marshalled itself. Here's to Wigamala in the side in place of Jason Robinson. Bradford wrestling him to the floor, Caudle and Newlove. Hall, dummy half, Edwards, this is Skerritt. Skerritt with a high drive right the way to the 10-metre mark. Hall is there, this is Edwards. Edwards trying to vary the option to play, Bell to Panapa.
Panapa was far too flat there, Bell wanted someone coming on screaming to it, but Panapa was flat to it.
Connolly takes the pass from Edwards, then he got the charge in from Medley, and he managed to retain possession despite the ferocity of that challenge. Here's Edwards, dabs it forward, Edwards. And it's Dave Watson there to tidy up the danger.
Edwards buzzing around, neat little kick through. Dave Watson playing in number 6, but they'll interchange fullback with Neil Summers.
10 minutes gone of this match, it's proving quite a spectacle, isn't it? Two sides with the biggest prize in the big league in their sights. The Stones bit a championship trophy. Wigan facing their moment of truth. Bradford know a victory and they would most certainly, well, almost certainly be champions come the end of the season. But a long week ahead of us yet.
Super kick from the man that knows this game inside out. Realises the importance of a good kicking game tonight. But full credit to this Bradford side. Normally teams that come to Central Park in the opening 10 minutes, they just play cautious. But Bradford really have kept this ball alive.
Peter Fox, is he the coolest man inside this Central Park cauldron tonight? I somehow doubt it. I bet his stomach is churning too. One last big effort he has asked for his players, and they're certainly producing it early on here. Watson making a strike for that ball a bit too early. Twigamala now has drifted infield.
Look at the size of Twigamala's thighs there. He certainly has the strength for this game. Whether he's going to have the stamina to last the full 80, we'll have to wait and see.
Good hands from Wigan. Betts' pass out wide found Dean Bell. Sure that Dean Bell is delighted to be back in this Wigan side too, with all the big games that are coming up. Skerritt again. Hall. Platt. Botica, good play from Wigan. Panapa. Panapa going for the corner. He's used a fire as a foil. Great try. Try number 18 of the season. A fire with a diagonal run. Took the Bradford defence out. And Panapa streaked in at the corner.
Panapa may have finished it, but it was good thinking from Martin Hall. A quick play of the ball. He made the initial ground that dragged in the defence tight. Botica out wide. Panapa runs at the angle. It was enough to just throw that little shimmy and dummy inside. It brought Carl Hall in the inside. He left it open. Look how Hall made that advantage, dragging three Bradford players. Boticar out wide, and look at the space. You see how he does the shimmy, and Hall comes back on the inside. It's enough to open the gate, and the 4 point is scored, and isn't he happy?
Gives everybody a wave, I'm sure, back home in New Zealand also. Remember these matches on a Friday night going live to the Antipodes. And Sam Panapa, try number 18 of the season. Just what the Wigan doctor ordered. For two then, Boticar with his first conversion attempt of the evening from way out on this left touchline. 139 goals for Boticar the boot. Will he reach 140 with this? If anyone can kick them, he can. The roar tells you, the flags confirm it, and Wigan are ahead 6-2.
You can see how quickly the run from dummy half has attracted three would-be tacklers from Bradford, and that created the overlap. Superb pass there. One Kiwi to another, and look at him set sail for the corner. A vital try at a vital time.
Wigan strike, perhaps a vital blow. 6-2 they lead, 14 minutes gone. Connolly in possession. Was that a high challenge from Furbank? Referee says play on. Cowie to Platt. Gets away from Newlove, Andy Platt. Wigan are starting to hit the straps.
And there's no better way to do it than have your forwards running like that.
Betts, good tackle in the end from Derek Fox, probably the smallest man on the field. Here's Edwards, now Boticar. Skerritt was there, the bounce pass though not the best, behind the Wigan runners, and the fire looks disgusting.
Rightly so, Boticar just sent it to no man.
Quarter an hour gone. Wigan lead 6-2. This most vital night. The most vital night of a long, hard big league campaign. Wigan desperate for the 2 points. Furbank with the drive. Bradford also keen as mustard. Furbank trying to release the ball. Bounced off his own legs, I think, and here comes Skerritt.
Well, that's two vital mistakes that I'm afraid Bradford have made. First earlier when Fox threw that awful pass that Clark retrieved. That put Wigan in a strong position. And there we saw Fairbank. Really, he should have gone to ground with that. Forward.
Referee's whistle blows. Platt ran straight into him. It was Hall's pass from the mark of the dummy half position that was just forward. John Holdsworth right on the spot.
Just a little slow there, the hooker Martin Hall, to get that ball away.
Watson finds Medley. Good tackle, Clark. Betts there too. Greenwood. Swarming defence from Wigan.
It's important now that Bradford settle down into the things. Do not panic. That'll be the key for them. Just work hard. Stick to the game plan.
Clark again, the dummy half. Fox, he saw Edwards had moved up to close his options down. That's tremendous Wigan defence.
He's a pass master, isn't he, Sean Edwards? You can see how he forced him down the middle.
The kick was straight into the arms of Twig Amala. Newlove and Caudle have got a job on their hands tonight. Bell, the acting halfback, to Edwards. Here's Connolly. Had a great game, Connolly, at fullback on Tuesday night, saying afterwards he doesn't particularly relish playing fullback anymore, but my word, what a performance he put in at Odsell on Tuesday. That's all the past, it's the present that counts, and he is a fire. Medley is with him, but the fire gets the ball away to Cowie, who prompts Connolly forward again. Cowie there to take the return pass, and Radford's tackle, suddenly Steve-O, are not sticking.
No, Wigan starting to spin in the tackle, and that's getting them the chance to get the ball away. They're also allowing Wigan time to run from dummy half. In the first 5 or 10 minutes, Wigan was finding it very difficult to get over that advantage line. Now they find it a lot easier.
Edwards kick over the top and into space. Carl Hall collects it. An interesting man, Carl Hall, came to Bradford Northern from Doncaster. Wonder if Doncaster win promotion as champions in Division 2 and Bradford win the big league, whether he'll get two medals this year. Dio Powell, Wenwich International. Derek Fox to Carl Furbank, two Great Britain internationals. The cream of the crop on the big league tonight. Summers. Strong run, but stopped by Platt, Cowie and Edwards.
It's obviously Bradford have realised they cannot take on this big Wigan pack. They want to play it out wide.
Derek Fox's kick just eluded Connolly for a moment. It's Fox who's led the chase, just as he did on Tuesday. Connolly, though, with the strength and the power to get away from three, but couldn't get away from Roy Powell. 6-2, Wigan ahead. O'Fire for Wigan. Saying in the papers this morning, Martin O'Fire, he's more and more drifting into the field of play to create better openings for his colleagues around him. Something that has developed in his play this season. Here's Bell.
I think he's had to. He hasn't had good service this season in my book.
Edwards the dummy half to Platt on the halfway line. That was a little knock off for Betts.
A bit overconfident there. Was on for half a chance, but Betts had overrun it. That's a key to this Wigan side. Spinning in the tackle, waiting for that second phase of attack. Unfortunately, Betts had just overrun that opportunity.
Fox gets the possession from that scrum for Bradford. That was Watson, this is New Love. Watson again, here's Furbank. We're midway through this first half. Greenwood, Wigan crowd roar forward, referee has none of it, play on. Clark there again, Fox gets away from Platt, tries to go through the gap between Platt and Cowie. Cowie hauls him down. They're in the danger zone, Bradford. Watson, long raking pass to Newlove. Newlove steps aside, Bell looks outside it for his winger. Corbett moved inside.
Chance gone begging there. Newlove had done the right thing. Step outside, inside, then look for the pass, and Cordland gone.
Cordland with a chance, and did he get the touch? It's play on. It's a try, is it? It is now. And everyone stood around, watched that. The referee has given the try.
Well, great play there.
But who got the touch?
Well, it wasn't General Caudle, because the referee's pointing to Connolly. Caudle kicked the ball through, and there it is. Connolly did get fingertips to it. That was play on. Wonderful positioning from John Holdsworth. Look how they look on, anxious to see what's going to come from it. Quick play of the ball, and look how the defence stood off General Caudle. They were going backwards. Fingertips from Connolly. It's play on from here. Nobody knows what's going to go on. But the referee, John Holdsworth, did. In for the try.
We think it's Summers who's been credited with the 4 points, and Fox uses the post again. 8-6, Bradford lead. Boos all round Central Park. Controversy in the big league.
Well, we're seeing a better angle here. You can see the defence there. Second marker was very poor for Wigan. Connolly gets a touch to it, racing through. They missed it, and here he comes along, the fullback. He's happy with it. Super play. You play to the whistle, and although the crowd went berserk, they thought that he was a knock-on from Caudle. You could see quite clearly the referee, John Holdsworth, was in a brilliant position. He said play on, and Bradford are back. They're leading.
8-6, Bradford lead. That's the important statistic as far as Bradford's concerned. He is Watson. Andy Farrell has come on for Wigan, and Neil Cowie, the second rower, is the man who's gone off. So John Dorahy makes the first change with a quarter of this match gone. Fox with the kick downfield. It was the kick from Gerald Caudle that undid the Wigan defence. Conley just tapped it, and as you say, Steve, that was play on.
No doubt about it, but the problem is with the Wigan defence was the fact that Caudle ran from dummy half. He must have gone 15 metres. Oh, that's a bad mistake. He said he lost it.
And he
got pulled out.
Twigamala lost it. Medley's collected the loose ball for Bradford. It's all happening here. Dio Powell to Furbank.
Well, this Wigan second marker, surely they've got to sort it out.
Here's Roy Powell, steps inside, and Farrell was there to cut him down. 15 metres from the Wigan line. Watson brings Dixon into it. Dixon, a champion with Halifax in 1986. Will he be a champion with Bradford in 1994? Furbank.
That's play on. Fairbank trying to release it. Desperate measures. Clark didn't knock on, it went backward. Did it to Wigan player? Did it bounce back in front? Referee Holdsworth said it wasn't offside. Whoa! Hold on to your hats.
Hall to the tall figure of Farrell. 18 years old, a veteran of two Great Britain internationals, Martin Hall, an able deputy for Martin Dermott. Edwards had a look, decided to drill the kick towards the corner where Caudle will collect it. What a new lease of life Caudle's had in the past fortnight. His kick caused all that chaos for Wigan. It's given Bradford the lead. Amazing though, Steve-O, that Derek Fox's two kicks so far have gotten in off the post.
They
can't be planned.
They all count. He'll be a relieved man. Certainly relieved of the fact that they've got that two-point lead.
Greenwood with the run. Of course, not just simply, and it's a big enough prize in itself, the big league championship pennant this season, but of course the trip to Brisbane and the World Club Challenge on June the 1st, beckoning this year's champions of the Stonesbitter Championship. And you'll be able to see that World Club Challenge live and exclusive here on the Rugby League Channel, Sky Sports.
Well, the kicking game has been superb so far from Bradford. Derek Fox obviously realising, you'll have noticed, they're not making any attempt to kick to Martin O'Fire's wing, which is good tactics indeed. They're all kicking towards Twigamala.
Botica now to Farrell. Panipa's there. Panipa through the gap. But Medley, funneling back, was the man who brought him down. And Medley just ankle tapping as Panipa tried to play that ball quickly.
Desperation by Medley there. It was a great tackle, but he realised that the Bradford defence was coming back onside. Just wanted to give them the extra few seconds to get into a solid line. But he paid the penalty, and what a severe penalty it can be when Wigan roll up a man like Frano Botica.
Yes, Botica has already kicked one tonight from way out on the touchline. Little swig from the magic bottle, and this is well within Frano Botica's range. 33 metres away from the posts. That's the angle he has. And this would put Wigan level. .317 points for the season now, Botica. It'll be .319 if this kick sails over. Really is a study in concentration. He has got the goal kicking off to an art. And that is the reason why the man, for me, is priceless, Steve-O.
It's just like a machine, well oiled, all the ball bearings not worn out, running so smoothly. And that is a problem that Bradford will have to overcome. They cannot afford to allow and give penalties away to allow that man Frano Botica to have a chance at kicking extra 2 points.
Botica gets the pass away to Farrell, who picks up pace. He's 18. Just look at the size of him. And there's a more relieved Wigan coach, I fancy, at 8-all. Skerrett. This is sport in the raw tonight. Platt. Two great sides, toe-to-toe, slugging it out for the biggest prize in rugby league.
And you just get the feeling that both Skerrett and Platt, old campaigners, they know what it's all about. And this man, Phil Clark, they've got to lead by example.
Here's Botica. Botica with a little dab over the top. Summers got to it, but he knocked it on. The pressure on Neil Summers as he went for this kick.
Beautiful play from Botica. Botica made no attempt to go for the football, but stopped at the last moment. He did not take Neil Summers out, but he just made Summers hold back for that split second, and it was vital enough to make sure that he knocked on.
Edwards to Botica. Wigan with a big chance here. Panapa. Furbank came from the base of the scrum to help out with the tackling. Here's Edwards. Edwards calls Skerrett into it. Skerrett with the run, met by Powell, finished off by Furbank. Hall is there, so too is Platt. Andy Platt dragging Wigan towards those posts. That's how close they are. Chance here for Hall, and Hall just hauled back. Botica back to Edwards. Edwards, long ball to Farrell. They have men out wide. The man is Twigamala, and Twigamala did well to stay in there at the first attempt, but then the sheer weight of numbers beat him and he was hauled out.
It had to take three to get the big man through. They nearly paid the price there. Newlove went far too high. Good job that Carl Fairbank was sweeping. The added weight was enough to take the big man over into touch. Bradford can breathe again.
Twigamala's had his moments in the other code, but I bet he has faced nothing like the ferocity and the intensity of this. Whoa, risky business from Bradford. Dio Powell had to leap for that pass. And Twigamala, the man who came in to bring him down. Fox.
Fox knew he'd just run into a brick wall. Skerritt's body.
Medley. Trying to drag Bradford out of the danger area. Clark to Furbank. Here's Carl Hall. Wrapped up by Ofire. Dio Powell at dummy half to Fox. Nowhere for him to go. Wigan are moving up so quickly in defence.
They're moving up quickly, but the big problem there was there was no one to go. Oh, he turns it down!
It down, chance here for Edwards' try! Edwards charged it down, and that's how important it is for him. Try number 14 of the season. It was play on. And Edwards first to react, tapped it forward, 4 points.
They got caught, Bradford. Their main kicker was held back. He was playing the football. Summers did not give himself enough room. And the master poacher has done it again. Sean Edwards, the man who so often, for the Cherry and White, produces something out of this world. His persistence has paid off. His patience was rewarded with 4 points.
He scored on Tuesday at Odsall, and he has scored here tonight. It's a little rub on the top of the head from Twigamala, but it was a tremendous piece of opportunism from the scrum half. Botica then, 2 from 2, from bang in front almost. It will be 3 from 3 in a moment, and Wigan will have a 6-point lead. No rush from Botica. precision. 14-6. 14-8, beg pardon. 14-8.
This is how a second marker should work, and that's where Edwards has got to. And that line behind is where Summers should have been stood. And he was repaid. Super stuff.
So Wigan ahead and in possession with Farrell. Both sides are fired up for this one. Skerritt. Head went back in that challenge. Perfectly legal with Medley. Platt now on the charge. Peter Fox watching anxiously from the dugout as Wigan start to hit the accelerator pedal. Hall is hauled down. Clark on his own from dummy half. Skerritt's there. Panapa out to a fire. Now a fire with the pace for the corner. Yes! Magnificent try from a fire. All the pace in the world. He was round Carl Hall before he could move. Great try. It's been an indifferent season, some might say. Look at that total.
A fire may have been on fire, but this guy was a match. He set it alight and the four was backed up superbly. Look at the pass out wide, in and out. See how he carried the ball right to leave his right hand to punish away anyone coming near. But this man has speed to burn. Once again, running from the dummy half, it was Clark. That's what made it. It dragged in the defence again, and that just gave enough room, and you can't give the man an inch. Full speed, top gear, 4 points.
Margin of fire, try number 25 of the season. Second on the all-time list of try scorers in the big league, behind his close friend, Ellery Hanley of Leeds. Botica again then with another conversion attempt. 100% so far. But Wigan suddenly have taken a stranglehold on this match with two tries in 2 minutes. Oh. Well, just enjoy goal picking at its finest. 20-8.
This is all it takes. One man out of the line and allowing the man to run from dummy half. Clark pulls him in. Three players go for the one man. That means an overlap. And when you have an overlap, this man has speed to burn.
The champions are in front. Let's go downstairs to Bill Arthur.
Well, Bradford, in the face of this Wigan onslaught, have gone for experience now. They've brought off young Deo Powell, who's had a bit of a nightmare match, especially in defence, and brought on the vastly experienced Dave Herron, and hoping that he can help them plug the gaps that are rapidly developing in that Bradford defence.
36-year-old David Herron, the oldest man on the field now. Sub on Tuesday. He's figured, though, in the last 22 Bradford Northern matches. Number 14, there he is, and vastly experienced.
Well, the Bradford coach, Peter Fox, fully aware that Wigan have scored two tries from allowing the dummy half to run so far wide. You cannot afford to let Wigan run riot like that.
Crunch time on Powell, Farrell and Skerritt. Here's Greenwood.
This is a display from the Wigan forwards that we have not seen for quite some time. They are eager, hungry for work, working together as a unit.
Last tackle here for Bradford. They're only just in the Wigan half of the field. There's Fox. That's a better kick. the regular kicker with the responsibility then, but he bounced once and straight into the arms of Connolly. And here goes Connolly. Good tackle though that by Neil Summers, scorer of the Bradford try. And noticeably, David Watson has dropped back to fullback for Bradford. And Watson, presumably then, is fullback with Summers at standoff half. And Newlove has it back for Bradford.
Trigamala went back to his rugby union days there, trying to get it away in an impossible situation. Was never on. And Wigan didn't go back the 10 yards. Penalty to Bradford. Desperate now that Bradford scored just before the break.
It would be a wonderful time for them. And they have the opportunity here now with Medley. Good run from Medley. Oh, he just dropped it, or was it stolen by Palapan? No. Play on.
Oh, wonderful run. Medley did everything right there. And I think that was taken over the fingertips there of Panapa. He didn't like it, Medley, but what a superb run.
Twigamala, faced by Caudle and Newlove. Again, they're trying to shuttle him out of play, but this time the big New Zealander will have none of that. Andy Platt, handing it as level pegging at 5-all.
Oh, they're getting cheap yardage now, Wigan. Quick play the ball. Bradford still going on the backward.
Botica, another little dink over the top. Dixon is there, and Dixon does well. Put his back to the on-rushing Botica. Retain the possession for his team. Greenwood can go nowhere.
Well, that's the third time we've seen Botica take the little chip over roll. And it certainly is working. It's applying a lot of pressure.
Good run that from Clark. There's Watson looking round for support. It was there, but lurking behind him with Newlove. Newlove cutting inside again. Great run this from Newlove. Connolly's there, Twigamala's there. And Caudle saying to the referee, that was a high tackle on Newlove. It's play on. Here's Fairbank to Roy Powell, who'll drive up the middle.
Great play from Bradford. But that surely should have been a penalty.
And it is. Phil Clark holding Roy Powell down as the Wigan defence got itself set for the attack.
There you see the master loose forward, Phil Clark. Professional through and through in many ways, more ways than one, should we say. Lucky there perhaps not to get the yellow card. Professional foul in the dying seconds of this first half.
Yes, Bradford were on a bit of a roll then, weren't they? Fox deciding, as we're in stoppage time first half, he will try for the two and cut the arrears to 10 points at half-time. Here goes Fox. Good kick. Slices through the woodwork this time. No post needed for assistance. It's Wigan 20, Bradford Northern 10. And good tactics from Bradford. There's the half-time siren. Tremendous first half. Botica with a magnificent kicking display for Wigan. And Bradford Northern hit by the tries, and Edwards, the master poacher. 20 points to 10. The champions have the advantage, but Bradford not throwing in the towel.
Seize the day.
The kickoff, the ball must travel at least 10 meters before either side can accept the ball and bring it back into play. Keep your eye on the non-kicking side player. He clearly moves over and inside the 10 meter line. This results in a penalty to the kicking side.
It's half time here at Central Park. Wigan 20, Bradford 10. I wonder how important that goal right on the stroke of half time from Derek Fox might be. But Botica with 4 out of 4, Panapa, Edwards and Afire, they're leading by 3 tries to 1. It was such a magnificent start too, wasn't it, for Bradford Northern. They really did take this game to Wigan in the opening 10 minutes, but Wigan gradually wore them down, and 20 points to 10, Steve-O. Fair reflection?
I think so. It took Wigan quite some time to get into the game, but full credit to Bradford. that option to open the play out very early in the piece certainly played off for them, because they had three clear breaks within the first 15 minutes. Quite frankly, I think that shocked the Wigan defence, and it wasn't long before the message was going out to the players, look, we've got to tighten it up. They were very bad on their second marker. Then all of a sudden, halfway through that first half, we saw a complete reversal. We saw that it was Bradford who were then taking a very slow movement back into the 10 metres, and their second marker was not working, and Wigan made them pay for it.
I don't think we've seen this season on the big league the Wigan forwards run with such venom and with such gusto.
No, it reminded me of Wigan of yesteryear. When I say yesteryear, perhaps last season, maybe 2 or 3 years. They've been so much at the top for so many seasons. But that, as you mentioned, the first time that we've seen 40 minutes of real powerhouse from the forwards. And Skerrich and Platt are leading the way.
They are indeed. I wonder if it's significant also that Betts and Clark are back in there. But this fellow, Martin Hall, has had a good game, hasn't he? The understudy for Dermot.
He's had a tremendous game. And this is the try that came about from, once again, poor second marking. It was good running by Hall that created this situation. But Panapa, beautiful inside pass there. That was a well-taken try, fully deserved. And believe you me, he showed a lot of pace.
And that was the moment, really, when I think Wigan started to believe in themselves that they could go and win this match, because they'd been on the back foot, hadn't they?
Well, Bradford had most of the possession in the first 15, 20 minutes. And once they started to play out their six, they started to use the forwards, driving in, and then a quick link. And we saw there, good run from Martin Hall, created the problems. Bradford have been caught out a couple of times, three men going for one Wigan player. Can't afford to do that against the Wigan side.
Indeed not. The Bradford Northern mistake started to creep in, didn't they? And, well, we've mentioned Phil Clark, and how important is he to this Wigan side?
Well, he surprised everybody, didn't he? I mean, he's just a tyro. He really gets into it. He adds a lot of punch to it, both in attack and defence. They've just kept it alive, and look at the strength. Look at the running on the forwards. That's what leads the way. Your three quarters are going to have a field day when you've got forwards who run with as much vim and vigour as that. Let's not take anything away from Bradford. They have just been totally outplayed. They played well in the first 15, 20 minutes, but it's been Wigan ever since.
They were leading 2-0, and then they led 8-6 after this try. Now, it confused a lot of people in the ground, but well done to Caudle for that. And you say play on, because Connolly definitely got a hand to it.
No doubt about it. And then we saw the second row, Paul Medley, have a go at it, and it just popped up there. Dio Powell said thank you very much indeed. It wasn't long after that Powell scores a try that he was being replaced. He was having a few problems with Powell, and then the man that always sniffs it out. We talk about the importance of good markers. We also talk about the importance of a bit of lady luck bouncing off the post, but you have to be there. And then again, look at this. Phil Clark, Skerrich, they're dragging two, three players to one man. Give him half an inch, he'll give you a mile. He's back to top form, Martin O'Fire. And what a time to hit top form when you can score tries like that. He's on song.
Bradford Northern's coach Peter Fox will be winding up his team in the dressing room for a big effort in the second half. It's certainly not over for them, even if they lose here tonight, but they have got no intention of giving this one away. Martin O'Fire, though, is running hot. We've a great second half to come. We'll be back in a couple of minutes.
Seize the day.
You're watching Sky Sports.
Only at your Rover dealer will you find a technician specially qualified to look after your Rover.
That's the situation here at half-time at Central Park. 20 points to 10. Champions in the driving seat against their nearest challengers. Bradford beginning the day, leading the big league table. Wigan in third. Statistics from the first half. Tackling, 66 by Wigan, 72 for Bradford. 4-3 to Bradford, the scrums. 4-1 in penalties. The handling errors, level pegging, and look at the possession. There's nothing to choose between the sides. Just 10 points at the moment, the gap between these two. Eric Fox knows perhaps the biggest 40 minutes of his career lie ahead. Dio Powell, scorer of that try for Bradford in the first half, has returned at the start of the second half. and Wigan emerge for the second 40 minutes here. Fano Botica, tremendous goal-kicking performance from him again. He's receiving words of encouragement from Sean Edwards. The Wigan scrum half tries now in four of the last five, and after tonight it'll be five in the last six. 2010 then, at the top of the Stones, bit of championship tonight. Will Wigan join Bradford up there and set us up for the most amazing week in the big league? We shall see. 40 minutes remaining. Steve-O, not underestimating it to say it's the biggest 40 minutes of the season.
It is for Bradford. 14 points adrift. They know they've got to really get into it, and that's a great start. Fairbank on Twigamala. And Twigamala just got up as though a flyer just brushed past him.
Ball hacked forward by Dennis Betts, who closes in on Carl Hall, who picked up the loose ball. Bradford in possession. Watson to Dixon. What will Peter Fox have said to his players at half-time?
He would have told them to not panic. That is the main essence of a chance for victory, to go through the actions like they did in the first 20. They had Wigan going backwards. He obviously would have said to them that they've got to tighten up this defence, especially around the ruck area. The second marker has to play tight.
Here's Newlove on the halfway line. Let's just confirm that Bradford have made a substitution. Their sub, David Heron's off, and Dio Powell, the man he replaced, is back on. Carl Fairbank struggling to his feet, trying to milk the penalty from referee Holdsworth, who will have none of it. Fox hoists the kick. Fox scampers after it. Connolly's underneath it. Took it well. The impact, though, forced him backwards, and Powell moving up cut him down.
Took it well, didn't he, the fullback Connolly. But a good tackle from Powell. And good work there from Twigamala. He's not frightened to come in and take a little bit of responsibility. Take some work away from the forwards.
The fire, that try's done in the world of good. He's leading the race. Now can he take Watson in and out? Well, Watson stuck to the challenge well, didn't he? And Gerald Caudle tracked him back too. But that has pushed Wigan into an attacking situation. Bell takes it over from Edwards. At 25th try of the season for a fire. And his confidence has come surging back. Here's Connolly. Connolly through the gap. He's got support out there. The ball was bounced off the chest of Panapa. There was a chance gone begging.
Superb centre play. Connolly giving the opportunity to Sam Panapa out wide. They just got the knee in the way. They'll play the first knock on. The head and feed to Bradford. They breathe a sigh of relief. But what a great run from Gary Connolly. Playing at fullback tonight, but chiming into the three-quarter line.
Neil Summers. Panapa pushed out of the way by Fox. Let's get on with it, he says. He's Adam Greenwood. And loads the ball untidily in his own quarter. That's risky play. Now Carl Hall. Here's Dio Powell again. Thought about the pass and then saw Phil Clark was there. Fairbank. Here's Fox. Dinks over the top. Watson is following it up. And Watson was hauled back by Edwards. But the referee says play off. Watson appealed to John Holdsworth then, claiming he was tackled without the ball, but the referee would have none of it.
Beautiful plant move though. Fox with a kick and Watson screaming up on the outside. He was onside there. With a 50-50, and you could see Edwards just pull the arm away to make sure that he wasn't going to be penalised. Once again, we see good work from Twigamala.
Oh, that was a little knee from Greenwood on Twigamala. Referee unimpressed, though, says play on, let's get on with it.
Just a little bit of a push, wasn't it?
Farrell. Wigan certainly streaming forward to support the man in possession of the ball, which is something they certainly didn't do against Hull Kingston Rovers last Sunday. It's a lovely kick from Edwards. drilled it along the ground, aimed for touch and found it.
Well, when you've got a pack of forwards that's going with so much vim and vigour, should I say, you can afford to just punch the ball into the corner, never mind about it staying in field. Okay, Bradford will gain possession, but the way that their defence is playing, they know they can keep them penned in this quarter.
Summers trying to get Bradford out of there. Really is a testimony to the progress that Bradford have made under Peter Fox, that they're in and challenging for this championship. Remember, two seasons ago, they were saved from relegation by a whisker. And of course, in the recent past, Wigan have inflicted heavy defeats in the Regal Trophy. But the gap between the two came a lot closer last season, and there's nothing to choose now, but that's a silly ball inside from Watson. And Clark again, the man sniffing for the opportunities.
Just panic football. You don't do that in your own half, especially near your own quarter. Ed was trying to milk it, didn't get it.
Hall to Bell, who called for that. Bell certainly back and leading from the front for Wigan tonight. Hall is there again. Here's Edwards, 10 metres out, long pass to Botica. And then on to Farrell. Farrell is there. Farrell with all the pace and power in the world to score. Oh, that was great play from the 18-year-old. Bradford was stretched out wide. Farrell cut inside. Try number 10 of the season registered.
You make the mistake and you pay the price. Beautiful long ball from Edwards there. He used the forward to run through, flat as a dummy. And Farrell running out wide, he throws the dummy there. You can see Hall, who's coming to the centres. And that is a great try. Big boys don't cry, they smile. Long ball from Edwards. See how he used flat as a dummy. And the big fella throws his little dummy. Steps inside. I'm afraid that Dixon was hanging back too much.
Andrew Farrell, only 18, Britain's youngest ever international forward, has the biggest of big futures in this game. Not a bad present. 4 from 4 for Botica. This conversion attempt to increase the Wigan lead. Just the start to the second half, this, that Wigan wanted. The start to the second half, I would fancy, that Bradford Northern dreads. Well, he's human. He's human after all, and he misses his first. 24 points to 10.
No, it's not Perm from any five, and it's not the Pools, but it's going to bring the jackpot for Wigan. Long ball from there, from Sean Edwards. You can't afford to do that. The big fella's running through. They use Betts as a dummy again. See how they just held off. Great try. Well worked.
Fox restarts. And there's been a change out in the field. Substitution news from Bill.
Well, Bradford Northern really have got to pull something out of the fire now. They've sent on John Hamer and pulled off Adam Greenwood. Hamer has scored his share of tries. They really do need to conjure up something now and soon if they're going to get back into this game.
Well, Hamer's last league try was way back in October 1992, but how he would like to get his season off the mark here tonight. Platt straight over the top of Derek Fox. Clark, another great run from Phil Clark. Wigan have lifted themselves for this game.
More cheap yards, that's what it's all about. Clark taking the opportunity, running from dummy half. They have not learned from their mistakes in the first half, Bradford.
Dio Powell, but Martin Hall stuck to him like glue. Fox and Furbank now. Thought about releasing the pass, and again they're taking far too many risks, Bradford.
Well, Fairbank trying to keep the ball alive. They have to do that. Summers probably called for it. But in that situation, going into the 50th minute, desperation, I'm afraid.
Skerritt. Lovely run from Skerritt, strength. Bit of finesse too from the big man as he stepped aside the challenges. Heyman leaning all over him as Skerritt tries to get to his feet. Hall to Edwards, another long pass from Edwards to Betts. Betts still going, bouncing off the challenges. But it was a good job that Trevor Clark stuck to the task. Hall is there, Edwards, Edwards to Clark. Keeps the ball alive, long pass out wide, a fire, 10 metres from the line. Having to come back before he goes forward. Thought about a kick and then straightened up. But Medley it was who tracked him all the way. 10 minutes second half, 24-10 Wigan.
What's
back with Boetticke, drop goal attempt. There's the extra one.
Superb call from Franno Boetticke. All the time in the world. Look at the space that he gave himself. No chance for Fairbank to charge that one down. Right over the black dot.
Sixth drop goal of the season for Franno Boetticke. It's 25-10. We're live at Central Park in this, the match of the season. And Wigan at the moment have lifted themselves for this, the ultimate challenge. And Fox pumps the ball out on the full from the kickoff. It's not going according to plan.
Bradford playing with a strong wind behind them. Fox didn't realise it was that strong. What must be going through the little fella's minds now? 51 minutes gone, 15 points in arrears.
Well, Adam Greenwood's rest on the subs bench hasn't been that long, only a couple of minutes in fact, because he's back on and Dave Watson is off. There were one or two doubts about Dave Watson's fitness before this game. Well, he really hasn't been firing on all cylinders, not as he was on Tuesday night in the win for Bradford against Wigan. So Adam Greenwood is back on. That means another reshuffle.
Let's confirm it. Watson off, Greenwood on, and having to defend this run from Andy Platt. Hall, good run, scampering stuff from the dummy half, Martin Hall. Trevor Clark there to wrestle him down. Wigan on the charge with Boetticke, now with Bell. Panapa, Edwards, Twigamana call for that, and Edwards gave it him short. Hall, last tackle, Edwards, and Bradford has stretched out wide again. It's with a fire.
Make him hurt, bringing the defence. Edwards runs at the angle, long ball out wide, desperation there, in and out. That is a great taken try, well played indeed. Twigamala it was that came in after Platt. You could see Martin the fire, arm raised saying I've got half a chance. He turns it into a full one. Beautiful pass from Edwards. See how they allow him to run across. They don't know what he's going to do. Medley takes a last minute plunge. And that is enough for the man to squeeze in.
Martin Afire, his first Wigan try against Bradford in 92. That try number 170 in the first division. From a prolific try scorer to a prolific goal kicker. Smiles on the faces on the terraces behind him. They are Wigan supporters. There are frowns on the faces of the Bradford Northern supporters at the moment. Boetticke just settling himself. Way out on the touchline. Hits the post. He misses another. Smiles though, 29-10, that's why he's smiling.
Edwards runs the angle, pulls in the defence. You can see the three guys waiting. He doesn't pick those, goes right over the top. And that had to be scored, well taken.
Bradford restart, this time they keep the ball in play. And Farrell, These two sides, their second meeting in the space of 4 days, on the 29-10. Wigan enjoying this, but the ball then was stolen on the Wigan player in the tackle, and Fairbank didn't like it. Doesn't like the decision, but the touch judge gave it. He gave the nod to John Holdsworth.
Well, he didn't like it because it took so long, but there was no doubt about it that Fairbank was involved there with Cowie. Referee, rightly so, looked towards the far touch judge. Touch judge nodded, said it was reefed out. That's what they're there for. They must combine.
Kelvin Skerritt, who has had a storming game so far, is off, and Neil Cowie in possession at the moment is on in place of him, and Skerritt got a rousing reception as he left the pitch because he really has helped get Wigan to this position of dominance.
And the man who has replaced him, Neil Cowie, has been adjudged to have dropped that ball. He then disputed John Holdsworth's decision, and John Holdsworth has given Bradford the penalty for back chatting. So Bradford Northern, they need something, and quickly too. 29-10. And of course, these two sides with two matches to play in the next week. And so this, perhaps the best title race for years, goes right the way down to the wire. There are the remaining fixtures for these two. Wigan, Castleford here at home, and then Oldham away, and it's Saints and Leeds awaiting Bradford Northern. What a finish to a sensational season. Hamer on the charge.
Still plenty of time though for Bradford to get back into this game. Two quick tries and this big crowd will go silent, I'll tell you.
Fox's little dab through the defence, but Connolly read the script perfectly. Here's a fire again. This time Dio Powell says you're not getting up the other end. Hall, the acting halfback. Dennis Betts, the runner. Tackler is Greenwood. Bell dumped to the floor by Clark. The other Clark almost through for Wigan. Last tackle. It's a good defensive stint this by Bradford, because Wigan are penned in their own quarter, and Farrell hacks it downfield. Not a bad kick. Underneath it though, Neil Summers. Summers runs it back, but look at Betts steaming in for the tackle.
Back to his best, Sydney Dennis Betts. Taking him a while to get back into the swing of things, but he really is in top form tonight, as all the Wigan pack have been. They have laid the foundation for the likes of Botica, Panapa and Edwards to take full advantage.
Here's Fox. Short ball to Powell. It was never forward, and neither was that. Fairbank on the charge. He's got support arriving from New Love, and New Love was well tackled by Connolly. Bradford, Fairbank to Fox, to Summers. Good play by Dennis Betts. He's had a nightmare season with injuries, Betts. Fractured cheekbone against the Kiwis. Shoulder problems too. But my word, he's come back bigger and better than ever. Here's Connolly.
Great positioning there by Gary Connolly, anticipating the kick. But he's worked hard, hasn't he, Betts, both in attack and defence.
I don't think it's a coincidence either that Dean Bell has returned to this Wigan fray. But it's the forward, Steve-O, have laid the platform for this 29-10 scoreline. And the backs starting to cut loose. Here's Panapa. Looks round for the support. No one there. That was a great tackle, as it turned out, by Summers. But Wigan are rolling forward again. A fire. Short ball to Bell. Out to Twigamala. Twigamala almost has the shorts pulled off him by New Love.
Well, it's no new secret that Wigan's success, big forwards working hard, lay that foundation. They've got the three quarters to finish it off.
Hall with a bit of space ahead of him. There's space there now for Betts. And Betts is through, is he? No, wonderful tackle from Neil Summers. Betts takes it to himself, makes a few more yards.
And one Sean Edwards was not happy with Mr. Betts' efforts there. You will see quite clearly after he's been tackled that Mr. Edwards had a few words to say to his teammate. And rightly so.
Glory was beckoning for Betts then. Bradford, the ball is to Fairbank from Fox.
He's one player that won't throw the towel in, Carl Fairbank. Not that I'm saying any of the Bradford side would, but Fairbank will go right to the end.
Carl Hall escapes. Now they've got support. Hall has got some pace. He's looking inside him for the on-rushing medley, but that was a good tackle by a fire. Mueller to Fairbank, Cordell's out wide, Cordell for the corner, oh, Connolly again, a measured tackle by Connolly.
You would have put your house on this, but what a great tackle by Connolly, sliding away, saves the day. How important would that have been? With 20 minutes remaining, Wigan may be in a comfortable lead. But as I mentioned before, two quick tries, convert them both, and the nerves start to tingle.
Terrific play from Gary Connolly. The scrum goes down, another change on the field. Bill.
Well, another man who's had a storming hour or so for Wigan. Phil Clark has come off. He was the surprise in John Durrahy's selection. Wasn't thought that he was going to be playing.
Cassidy has dropped it though, his first touch. It's a chance here for Dio Powell. Gets the ball out wide, they're in with Medley. Bradford Northern, oh, what a tragedy for Cassidy. And Cassidy trying to bundle Medley into the stand. And Cassidy, the man who dropped it. Cassidy, the man who surrendered possession. Medley, the man who scored what could be a vital 4 points.
Not exactly what a substitute needs to do. Never really had full control of that. And our mistake can change the game. Carl Hall kept his cool, wasn't the best pass there. Dio Powell, fingertip control. They looked as though they had it sorted out, but there you can see Medley out wide. Quite frankly, the Wigan side just gave up a little bit. Medley came round enough to perhaps make it easier for Fox's attempt for the conversion.
So Bradford narrow the gap, those two are smiling, Medley and Dio Powell, and Fox needs to kick this, but he hasn't. Looks ruefully over his shoulder at those posts. 29-14 now, Wigan.
This is the pressure you apply when you make the mistake in your own quarter. You can see the Wigan side. They were lining up to take it away, safety first. Well done from Powell there. Back inside, I thought he bombed it, but it's open way there. Through the gates, maybe not of paradise, but they're still in with a chance.
They are in with a chance. 15 points the difference. If Bradford needed any encouragement for the last quarter of this match, they've just had it. Bradford, last season third, league leaders before tonight, head-to-head and toe-to-toe with the champions for the past four seasons. It's a thriller at Central Park. Great run from Hall.
And great work from Sean Edwards there, he clung on like life.
Here's Roy Powell. Turning in the tackle again, Powell. Last tackle here for Bradford. New love the dummy half, Clark was blowing. High kick from Fox, who chases after it himself. Edwards is underneath it, and New love flattens Edwards.
Concentration supreme there from Edwards. He knew that New love was coming. Express train stuff. Professionalism coming out now. I can't play, let someone else do it.
That was a bad ball, Twigamala. I think called for it, but the ball went free and a fire picked it up. And he has run down the alley.
Well, it was a mistake that led Bradford back into this game, and that could have played dearly again. Then the nerves would have been tingling. Another 6 points, 29-20.
Here's,
Bradford do have the firepower. When a side's got the man like Paul Newlove in your side, he can produce a try from nothing.
Edwards, short ball, Bell. Last tackle here for Wigan, still in their own half of the field. It won't be now because Edwards is going to put boot to ball. Well read by Neil Summers. He darts his way forward. Hanapa is there.
Could see the look of disgust on Sean Edwards' face then. He knew it wasn't a good kick. Straight down the throat of Neil Summers. He wanted to get way past him into the corner.
Now, Dixon. Possession, Wigan's second half so far. But Clark, good run through Cowie, but couldn't get away from Hall.
Quick play of the balls, Wigan are starting to tire. They're missing a few tackles.
Powell, good ball to Hall. He gets away from Panipa. The support out wide. Hall wants it on his own. Perhaps he should have flung it out wide. Last tackle. Summers is there. This now is Derek Fox. Fox, good ball to Clark. Here's Newlove. Newlove looking round for support. Medley's there. They continue it with Cornell. Cornell runs round the back of Powell. Goes for the line, Cornell, and is just held up. Great attack from Bradford. Great defence from Wigan.
Champagne football from both sides, and that's a lost ball. That'll be a knock on. Talk about the pressure. You can see it was Cornell. He had more attention on the head rather than the football, but it squeezed it out nonetheless.
Wigan's eighth handling error of this match. How important could it be? Scrum 10 metres from the line. Fairbank gets the possession from the base of that scrum. Makes just 1 metre of progress. Fox wants to get on with it quickly. Vital moments here for Bradford. Summers is there. Here's Newlove. Tries to get away from Platt. Newlove with the run to the line. Swigamala with the tackle. Summers again says to the referee, come on, we want to get on with it. Here's Derek Fox. Closed down by Cassidy. And also Martin Hall. That's how close Bradford are. Summers. Long pass out wide. It bounces kindly. There's a chance here for Powell. Gets the ball away to Medley. Was that forward? It was. No try. Medley can't believe it, but it was forward.
Dio Powell can't believe it either. Stepping inside. Fingertips to just flick it away there with all the attention around him. And Paul Medley thought that Christmas had come early. The chance was there. And I tell you what, there's not much in it.
John Holdsworth was positioned perfectly to make his decision. And Medley has been hurt in grounding the ball. And so we have a stoppage in play while he receives treatment. It looks like he caught the knee there of the Wigan player. Right in the ribs, that's painful. And of course, Medley, one of the forward pack in the second row. That's why referee Holdsworth is holding up the play. I'll be all right, he says.
Well, what a vital decision that could have been from the referee, John Holdsworth. It's a replay again. Up it goes. I'm not so sure. I think that was straight. Straight as an arrow. But it bent as far as the referee, John Holdsworth, was concerned.
Well, in this season of Big League, Steve-O, we have seen plenty of forward passes. A lot less forward than that. But John Holdsworth is the man who makes the decisions. And he's made, perhaps, one of the biggest. Fairbank was in no mood to let the fire get away and just patted him on the backside for good measure.
To be fair though, John Holdsworth has had a big game. He's allowed this to go. There's been a lot of niggling. He's allowed them to get on. The crowd have got their money's worth, that is for sure. This has been a cracker.
Exactly what you'd expect from the two main contenders in this heavyweight championship. And Tuigamala trying to make a name for himself. Gets the ball up to Bell, back to Tuigamala. Yeah, the crowd have had superb value for money tonight. Cassidy, I'm sure you have at home too watching this. Rich entertainment. And still a little over 10 minutes to go. Plenty more. Betts stepping through the challenges. Betts had his best game for a long time. Mind you, he's hardly been in the side since Christmas. Edwards. Oh, lovely ball to Boddicker. Ball comes out. Hacked against the post. Is it play on? Referee says yes, play on. Because Bradford have it with Fox. That could have been so dangerous. Wonder what his decision would have been if it would have come back to a Wigan jersey.
Would have been play on. Exactly the one that Holdsworth used. This has had everything.
Powell. Four tackles gone here for Bradford Northern, still deep in their own half. That might have been forward. Over the shoulder goes one from Furbank, and Fox picked it up. That's the last tackle. They're trapped in their own half, Bradford. And Fox, the man playing the ball, he's the main kicker. It's back with Summers. One bounce. Connolly. O'Fire wheels round. Gets away almost from New Luck, who I think almost had hold of his sweatband then to bring him down.
Got some pretty close attention from Fairbank then.
No one in the market at the dummy half position for Wigan for a moment. Boddicker moved in, then gave it to Twigamala.
He's played his part,
hasn't he? Just.
I thought he may have been a weak link in defence, but he's done exceptionally well.
Farrell, Wigan are rolling forward again. Betts gets the ball away to Panapa. Dale Powell with the tackle. Edwards. Cassidy. Last tackle for Wigan. Edwards. Here comes the... He fancies a one-pointer. They sliced it. Underneath it is Cole. Got it second, or was it third attempt?
Good thinking, though, by Sean Edwards, realising that that would take up time, even if it missed as it did. The ball went deep.
Well, Sean Edwards just looking ruefully there at the posts and remembering, I'm sure, his last one-pointer was against Bradford in the Cup. Let's go downstairs. Bill Arthur's got Daryl Shelford of Bradford with him.
Daryl, 10 minutes left, 15 points in it. Do you think you can get that back?
Well, we're trying very hard. I think the way Wigan are playing, we could pick up a few points, but I'd say we've got to just try and keep ourselves fit for the last two games of the season.
If only that last effort in the corner had stood.
Yeah, if Paul Medley had been able to hold that ball, we could have come back into it quite well.
Cornwell with the run. A bit of space for Cornwell, but it was quickly closed down. And it was Boddicker doing the challenging. Hall gets it away to Hamer. Hamer trying to roughhouse his way to the line. The support pouring forward. But the referee says that was the last tackle. And it's the turnover just a metre from Wigan's line. Bradford are pushing them all the way here.
They're playing super football there. They're making the break. New Love showing his strength and skill.
Cassidy with the run. His first touch was a mistake. Produced Bradford's last try. That's the sort of play that Cassidy has produced most of this season for Wigan. To Twigamala, up to halfway. Edwards to Farrell. Farrell.
Play. It was Twigamala that set it up with a strong run, but look at the dummy there from the substitute Andrew Farrell. So strong, just brushed it away, kept his cool, dragged Neil Summers towards him, And hat-trick time for Martin O'Fire. Excellent play. Look at the strength in this man. They used the dummy on the inside. He used Panapa coming back. They just held off enough. And this man has so much strength. The youngster kept calm and cool and collected. This man is back in top form.
A hat-trick of hat-tricks for Martin O'Fire. That's his third three-try haul of this season. Botica, 4 from 6. Will it be 5 from 7 in a moment? Will it be 2 priceless points for Wigan at the end of this match? I think it will now. But credit Bradford, they've pushed them all the way. Wigan. The match, I fancy, is in the keep net now, 35 points to 14.
This is what you call teamwork. You see how Panapa is running on the inside. It allows Farrell to just throw the little dummy, and away he goes. They're just held away. He is so strong. We keep saying he's a star for the future. He's a star now. Great Britain cap this year, Farrell. Super stuff.
Martin O'Fire's second hat-trick in successive home games. Bradford restart, 4 minutes to go, 35 points to 14. If you're a big league viewer, by the way, on Sky, do not switch off after this match is finished tonight. We have some important news to give you before we go off the air tonight at 9:30. This result has repercussions for the end of the season, and what a boiling end of the season it's going to be. And for some great news for big league fans, stay tuned. Andy Platt with the run.
Well, you're talking great news. I think the biggest cheer from the crowd here at Central Park is the fact the way that Boiga Twigamalan has played.
Farrell still running. Farrell just slipped and lost the boot as he went down. Wigan have run very hot tonight. Edwards gets the ball away to Bell, wrapped up by Hamer, but he slips the pass to Panapa. Long ball to Hawley, call for it, gets it back to Botica. Botica to Platt, to Twigamala's there. Twigamala's hit the gap, it's all yours, Inga, but it's a forward pass. Forward pass.
Either way, he went
for nothing.
He went short. They won't give him this one this time. Just a little bit delayed there from Platt, but look at the enthusiasm of Twigamala. He's enjoyed it tonight. He's certainly silenced quite a few knockers that said Wigan perhaps had forked out a fortune for someone that may not make it big. Well, I tell you what, tonight he's shown enough to me that he will make it. No fear about that.
Taking a knock, he's receiving treatment as you speak. Bradford in possession with Powell, keeping it going to the end, and credit to them for that. Slipped the pass to Powell, and that was forward. Roy Powell to Dio Powell. Holdsworth whistle is shrill.
Well, the throw of the dice perhaps has not been going Bradford's way late in this game. But full credit to them, they've kept it going. Both sides deserve a great pat on the back. Both sides extremely tired. The run into this championship, a lot of games in such a short period of time.
Coming up to the last minute of normal time, plus the stoppages. Fairbank on Bell, high. Bell flattened.
Certainly was. Came in right underneath the chin. Here comes Fairbank. The arm on top of the shoulder took some of the impact. Fairbank gave Bell a little pat on the back. Not so sure Bell realised what on earth was happening.
So into the last minute, Wigan ending strongly with Cowie. Hall to Edwards, to Platt, back to Edwards, long ball, Bell, Botica. Now it's Panifa. Grounded on the 20 metre mark, 35-14, 6 seconds normal time left. Cassidy, good tackling, Powell and Greenwood. Hall back to Edwards, little backhanded pass to Bell. Dixon hauls him down.
Is it time for one of the big forwards to take some of the glory tonight? They deserve it.
Now they fancy another one pointer from Botica. This time he pulls it, hooks it wide of the posts. We're in time added on by the timekeepers. Central Park waits for the final siren, and this will set us up for the most blockbusting week of the big league season.
Sure does. Don't take your holidays. Cancel them.
Hall is brought down. This is Fox. Fairbank. And the knock-on is the decision by referee Holdsworth.
A tired Carl Fairbank. He's given his all. A few of them have. Tired outfits. They'll look forward to this hooter.
Yeah, the tired boys out there now. Two big matches between these two in 4 days. It's taken its toll, but you wouldn't think so looking at Edwards. Or a fire. He's got three. He wants four. Bell takes over from him. Gives it to Botica. Betts over the top to Farrell. Now to Connolly. It is to Wigan.
The provider gets his just desserts in the end. Wigan quite happy to just play basketball style football, keep it alive. Bradford, a very tired outfit indeed. And the man who's one of the best support players in the world today, Sean Edwards, shows his delight. The run around. Look at the tired defence, they were nowhere in sight. The fire, in and out, in and out. I've done enough, come on, help me. And it's here, come on Dino, he gets involved. Frano tries to it. It's all basket style, basketball style. But the power and the strength is showing now. And the superb support play provides the crowd with plenty to cheer.
Seven tries, two for Sean Edwards. Botica bang in front. The extra two. Wigan joined Bradford at the top. 41-14, it's all over. Sean Edwards and Inga the Winger. It was a big game for Wigan and Bradford. Wigan have come out on top. And it's their supporters who are celebrating, and no one will celebrate longer or harder tonight, I'm sure, than teetotal Martin Afire. Three tries for him. Downstairs quickly, Bill is with Phil Clark.
Bill, the victory you wanted.
Yeah, we needed it. It was a do or die game. It only puts us back in the race now, along with Bradford and Warrington, so although we can rejoice in playing well and a lot of confidence was shown tonight in the Wigan team, we still know that there are two games to go and it's up to us to win both those games.
Bradford got off to a storming start, might have scored in the opening few minutes, so the nerves were obviously there.
Yeah, I think that's right. I mean, perhaps a little bit over-aroused for the game. We see one or two lads missing tackles, but at the end of the game we played very well, so we came up with a win.
Still two games to go, it's not yours yet.
No, definitely not. It's still a three-horse race. We're in there with Warrington and Bradford, and it's just up to us to play to the best of our ability.
Derek Fox disappointedly trudges off the field. because of that full-time scoreline of 41 points to 14. The champions hit top form against Bradford, who contributed to a truly memorable match. Sensational game on Sky tonight, and the champions back in business.
Seize the day.
You're watching Sky Sports. To make the playoffs, Charlotte must beat Orlando. Tonight, 9:30, Sky Sports.
Now, here's a unique opportunity. Own your own chilled premium lager in rich gold and frothy white. Brewed in the traditional method by genuine German craftsmen. It comes complete with this stylish glass carrying case and a guarantee that all the sugar is turned to alcohol. Don't delay. Buy one today.
Funny looking soap.
Not as funny as you. Anyway, it's not soap. It's Biactyl.
Helps keep my spots under control.
But you're not spotty.
That's because I use Biactyl every day.
But why if you're not spotty?
Because I don't want them back.
But why?
Bacteria in the skin cause spots. Biactyl kills more bacteria than ordinary soap. In fact, it's twice as effective. Looking good. So could you.
Daily washing with Biactyl beats soap at beating spots.
Do you like the fresh fragrance of spring in everything you wash? We've captured it for you in the fragrant fabric softener that goes into Bold Spring Fresh. Or maybe you prefer the evocative fragrance of a summer meadow. If you do, you'll be pleased to hear we've captured that too. New Bold Summer Meadow Fresh or Spring Fresh. Now there's a choice of freshness for your wash.
New from JVC, Adagio Hi-Fi Systems. Beautifully sculptured. Moving speakers to put you in control of your music. Adagio Hi-Fi Systems from JVC.
Crest? Yes. But 6 months ago, Jenny had fillings.
I couldn't believe it. I felt so guilty. So this time I made sure that she brushed properly and used a good fluoride toothpaste to fight decay. Crest, it really works.
Plaque acids can cause weak spots, but Crest Fluoride System Fluoristat helps put calcium into weak spots to help stop cavities before they start.
Next visit was a completely different story. Wasn't it, Jen?
Crest. Help stop cavities before they start.
From Milky Way. Collect three wrappers and they're yours for $1.99. Then magic!
Very nice of you to take me out to dinner, Money.
It's the least I could do, Access, after everything you've done for me. I remember you helped me move into my first flat. And you were there when checkbook ran out on me.
I even helped you keep in shape.
While Fat Wallet lost a few pounds. The time you just phoned up and got front row seats for the ear bashers.
How could I forget?
So this one's on me.
The bills, sir.
Oh, dear.
Need any help, Money?
Thanks, Access. Leave a good tip.
Access, your flexible friend.
I'd just like to say that Holston Pills is brewed twice, in case you weren't paying attention the first time.
Star-spangled sports movies this weekend on the Movie Channel. In baseball, there was only one.
Babe Ruth.
John Goodman is the Babe, the television premiere.
It's hard got their work being this good.
Woody Harrelson, Wesley Snipes.
White men can't jump.
The Saturday night premiere. And Gina Davis, Tom Hanks, and Madonna are in a league of their own. Then it's football action all the way in Necessary Roughness. A bruising lineup of star-spangled sports movies this weekend, only on the Movie Channel.
Seize the day.
41.214. Wigan have answered their critics in emphatic style. A fire 3, Edwards 2, Panapa and Farrell for good measure. Botica with the 6 goals and the drop. Dio Powell and Medley for Bradford. Fox with 3 goals. It was brave stuff from Bradford Northern, but to Wigan, the spoils. Sean Edwards, their 2-try hero with Bill.
Sean, that's a victory that really puts you right back in the hunt, doesn't it?
Yeah, we've got 2 very hard fixtures to come. Castleford are a top team. They're coming here next Wednesday. Obviously, they don't want us to win anything because the success we've had in the past, and we're a very tough tie at Oldham, you know, the last game of the season.
To come back from Tuesday night when you suffered that defeat at Oddsall like this really is some effort.
Yeah, I think the pitch helped, you know, a dry track certainly helps our team. And Merton, I thought Merton was outstanding tonight. Showed his pace, excellent, 3 tries, can't ask for more than that.
Well, he only scored 1 more than you.
Yeah, yeah, I think the first one of mine was a little bit fortunate. But I've been chasing kickers all season without much success, but, you know, thank God it was today, you know, when we really needed it.
Still 2 games to go, of course it's not settled yet.
Oh, no, not by a long, long shot. Like I said, Castleford and Oldham, they'll be after our scouts, and we've got to get a bit of consistency, which, you know, really, we haven't really had all season.
Yeah, it's not over by a long chalk, is it? That's the way it looks tonight. 28 games for Wigan, Bradford, Warrington, 42 points for them, and they're the points difference, and they are the remaining games for Wigan, Bradford and Warrington. Who's your money on? Take your choice. Now then, Martin Afire scored a hat-trick tonight, and he's with Bill.
Martin, another hat-trick. What a time to get it.
Oh, yeah, over the moon, you know. Back to the wall after, you know, a defeat, a narrow defeat against Bradford. But, you know, that's come to our patch, and we were just over the moon to win tonight. We know we haven't won the league, you know. We never get carried away at Wigan. We were just, like, so relieved to win this one game.
Just being outside the dressing room this evening, you could feel the nerves jangling. What was it like inside the dressing room?
It was very quiet. You know, we came to play. It was like Challenge Cup, you know. If we died today, we could kiss it goodbye. But we're still alive. We haven't won it, but we're still alive.
Yes, and to go into the remaining 2 games after a win like this really does set you up, doesn't it?
Yeah, 1 game at home and 1 away. If we win those 2 games, we won the league. It's simple as that, you know. You don't need to get your slide rules out, your calculators. It's just as simple as that.
And how much sort of incentive was there after that defeat at Bradford going into this game?
Oh, there was a lot of incentive. I thought particularly that we played quite well. We made 1 mistake and Bradford punished us. Bradford are a very good side. They can beat sides who play very well. You don't have to play badly to lose to Bradford. And so we knew we were quite confident on a dry pack, you know, a dry park, sorry, you know, in front of our great home spectators. We had to play well. And thankfully, we got a few chances and we scored enough tries. Yeah, I just want to say a big yo to our mate Chris because he's watching in London. See you on Sunday in the sauna, yo.
Yo, indeed. And don't forget on Sunday, if you're in the sauna with Martin, tune in to us at 10:30 on Sunday night. It's Castleford Warrington. Now then, what have we got coming up for you next weekend? Hang on to your hats and watch this. Next Friday at 7, it's Warrington Sheffield, live and exclusive here on the Big League, on Sky. Here's the big news. Saturday, we'll be on the air at 2 for Leeds Bradford, live from Headingley. Leeds against Bradford on the Saturday. And on the Sunday, a bonus, live at 7. It's Oldham against Wigan. That's the big news I promised you during the course of the match. You can't get better service than that for the big league than here on Sky Sports. 3 out of 3, live, here on this channel next week. Great news for us, great news for you, and great news for Wigan, Steve-O. They're back in business.
They certainly are, and it was Wigan of old tonight. They really did get back into the swing of things. Over the past few years, Wigan have just crucified the opposition. The forwards have set the scene. They make the springboard for the 3 quarters, and it was on display tonight. It was a pack that was moving forwards. Okay, they were a little bit shaky in the first 10, 15 minutes, where Bradford looked very sharp indeed. But then on, it was just a matter of roll the sleeves up, and the forwards really did take control.
Yes, they did. The forwards were magnificent for Wigan tonight. So too was Edwards. In fact, you'd be struggling really to pick him out of the match, but look at this try from a young man called Andy Farrell, who's only 18, Stephen.
Not bad, is it? As we mentioned in the broadcast, the fact that he's a star of the future, well, he's a star now, well and truly. Beautiful dummy inside, but it took someone to come on the inside to bring the defence across. They played as a team, Wigan, tonight, and it will take a very good side to stop them when they're in this mood.
Well, it will, and there's 2 matches to go. Bradford didn't have the answer tonight. I wonder whether they have next week. A fire, look at him, hand up, screaming for it. A hat-trick tonight for the winger.
Well, he's on.
That took some scoring.
My word, he was on song, wasn't he? It's all a matter of the fact that Sean Edwards, we said before the game, that if Sean Edwards starts attacking the defence, then Wigan can be lethal. But you've got to have the forwards driving. They took them into the position. They brought the defence in from Bradford. A long ball from Edwards. He's one of the best in the business. And when you've got finishing power like that out wide, Martin O'Fire, they've got to be good.
Three teams in it. 28 matches gone, two to go for each of them, 42 points each. Wigan, Bradford, or Warrington?
I think you'd have to say Wigan, mainly because of the fact they've got a better scoring average.
OK, there you are. Steve-O says Wigan, but you'll be able to follow it all to its ultimate climax right here on Sky Sports. Castleford-Warrington on Sunday at 10:30. Highlights from Weldon Road. Then next weekend, the big bonuses start coming your way. Warrington Sheffield, live and exclusive from Wilderspool Stadium next Friday night at 7 o'clock. That's one that Warrington must win. But this is the big news. We've got a match on Saturday. And what a match. Leeds, the Challenge Cup finalists against Bradford, going for the championship. Live and exclusive at Headingley. We're on air at 2. Kick-off time, 2:15. Best to be there. If you can't be there, be with us on the big league. And on Sunday, another bonus, because we go live at 7 for Oldham against Wigan. And Oldham have been known in the past to shake Wigan up. There's nothing easy. And all those three matches you will be able to see right here on Sky Sports. Fantastic end to the season, isn't it? Not only for the teams, but for the viewers to Sky Sports. Without a doubt, the Rugby League channel, and we're taking it to the wire with you over the next 7 days. Join us Friday, Saturday, Sunday. They're all live, they're all exclusive, and they're only in one place. That's right here on Sky. Hope you've enjoyed this one tonight. It's been a thriller. Absolutely breathtaking. Well done, Wigan. Who's going to win the championship? Find out next week.
This Saturday on Sky. On Sky Sports at 2:30, live from Antigua, the West Indies take on England in the fifth test. And that means Premier League football moves to...